what we wanted to see.
This car isn't staying blue. Behold, the Irish Green 996 is upon us. There's a bit of a surprise coming up on the back of the car. I am so happy. Okay, so in this series documenting the restoration and renovation of my 996 Carrera so far, most of it has focused on the bodywork and obviously taking the wrap off, painting it Irish green, etc. There's also a few little stylistic touches that I wanted to implement on the car as well, including a bit of duck time. This, as you can see by that beautiful weave, is carbon fiber goodness. Lightweight, strong, beautiful fit, extremely heat resistant. This particular ducktail is from RPM Technik and their CSR range, second generation. But as ever with my videos, I'm all about education, which is why a few weeks back, I went up to Daventry to watch this being made and also find out exactly how carbon fiber is made in this day and age. Take a look. Now, aside from carbon fiber looking absolutely awesome, it has many engineering advantages too. For example, it's extremely lightweight and it's incredibly strong. The use of carbon fiber has also increased tenfold in the last decade or so. It's heavily used in marine industry as well as on aircraft. It's almost ubiquitous in automotive circles too. But how exactly is it made? Okay, so carbon fiber, which is essentially string with thousands of parallel filaments woven together, is an amazing, amazing product. It's 3 times the strength of aluminium, but only half the weight of steel. These days, the material can be molded into all manner of complex designs, and yet the build process is still done pretty much entirely by hand, as seen on my visit to MCT. They've made nothing but carbon fiber products for the last 25 years and count half of the F1 grid, most leading European car manufacturers, and even a company famously reimagining the 911 among its client base. To get a product such as RPM Technik's CSR ducktail to market, first the design is laser scanned in situ and turned into a 3D CAD model. It's then CNC machined into a block. The mold and tooling is made, also from carbon fiber, and then it's all tested and signed off. Only then can the production process begin, which is the same for all clients and products. First, a frozen pre-preg material is CNC cut and then hand laid into the mold, as seen here on what turned out to be my very own CSR ducktail. Once inspected, the mold is sent off to a vacuum bagging room, which sucks out as much air as possible from the construction. The reason for this is, the more air you get out, the more structurally sound the product is. From there, it's put into an autoclave, which to you and I is a high pressure oven, for a standard cure of 35 degrees for 3 hours. After another quality check, the product is then sent to the trim shop for final assembly. A further quality check follows before moving, if appropriate, to the paint shop. My CSR ducktail was delivered in raw carbon, but in the interest of seeing this process through, I followed some parts being made for a leading British automotive manufacturer, where, after a lacquer and polish, the product is supplied to the client. About those quality checks, there are between 7 and 9 throughout the entire manufacturing process, and that's the same whether the product is destined for a Formula One car or the backside of my 996. The reason for this is there's no point carrying a faulty product forward to say 0.9 when it was in fact defective from an early stage. This saves a lot of time and money, where the industry standard failure rate is a monumental 30%. So how on earth do people manage to run a business making this stuff? I asked a man who knows a thing or two about that very question. So I'm joined by David Joseph, who's MD here at MCT. David, thanks very much for your time to begin with.
You're very welcome.
Something that I have learned quite comprehensively today is just how time exhaustive this whole process is to make a part, whether it's an RPM ducktail or, for example, here, the adaptive spoiler on the back of a 918 Spider, which was made here at MCT. What's different to anything else I've seen in the automotive industry so far is it's still handcrafted.
Pre-preg, hand laid up, it's still the best. It's still how, as you've seen on your day here today, there's Formula One parts being made for the top teams, automotive parts. It's the same process, and it is in some respects it's quite nice that it is a handcrafted part made by, and obviously by, you know, very skilled individuals.
In the past 10 years, I just think carbon fibre is diversified. From an engineering and manufacturing point of things, what's had to change here for you guys?
I think for us, we started as a, and still are, a Formula One shop, motorsport shops, probably about 10 years ago. The demand for it in the mainstream automotive and we're talking obviously still the high end. It was just a new learning curve of what their constraints are after. For example, in a motorsport, they're not necessarily after aestheticness. They want it to be structurally integral, you know, homogenous, whatever it might be. Whereas for the automotive, they also want, they like it to be as you know, obviously structurally sound for doing what it needs to be, but there also has to be an aesthetic view to that as well. It has to look nice.
What do you think is the future of carbon fibre then? Porsche, for example, on their new Cayman GT4 Club Sport, some of the body panels are a plant-based fibre now rather than carbon fibre. So what do you think to that?
Yeah, I think that carbon fibre, I think we'll always, you know, the properties that it offers, and it's still, for the automotive industry, it's still sort of in its infancy. You know, motorsport's been around for a long time, but I think there's still a lot of ground left in that. I think there is a big push for new processes, trying to automate it, speed things up a little bit, you know. There were compromises all along that way, though. And I think, again, we've already been making some parts for certain people in hemp, which is, you know, in flax as well. So, again, those plant-based materials, exactly that.
All right, David, well, look, I really appreciate you guys letting me come and have a look around today. It's been genuinely fascinating. So thanks very much indeed.
Brilliant. You're very welcome. Thanks very much.
OK, so that was the carbon fibre factory. And here is the end product. Does feel supremely special. I understand all of the craftsmanship and the dedication and, to be honest, the time that goes in to create something like this. It's genuinely a bit of a work of art. I've watched this being made by hand in front of my own eyes. It's a British made product. I've put this next to the original deck lid because I want to highlight some of the advantages of having a carbon ducktail over this. Now, yes, this is extremely expensive owing to the fact A, it's carbon fiber, B, it's handmade, but as I said, there are many, many advantages to carbon fibre. One of them being lightweight, another one being particularly strong. I'm also hoping this is going to generate a little bit more downforce at the back of the car as well. You might remember my top speed runs on the autobahn a couple of videos back. The car just felt completely unstable, if I'm honest. So I'm hoping this is going to provide a little bit more downforce. But for now, I just want to compare the weight. I tried to find some luggage scales, but Mrs. K Sibbs has delightfully hidden them from me. So we're going to guess. That is a heavy, heavy, heavy piece of kit that I would estimate to be 10 kilos. Could be completely wrong, but I'm going to have to trust me on it. The ducktail, meanwhile, as you saw earlier, super light. Again, I haven't been able to weigh this officially, which is a bit of a crying shame, but let me tell you, having picked this up and whirled it around for the morning, I would say that this here carbon fibre ducktail is no heavier than my driver's side front mat. Which is absolutely nuts when you think about it. So I would say that's at least 10 kilos saved, quite high up on the car. Again, looking at the finish, everything's in place. For example, the fan underneath this to transfer straight over. This should be, and again, this is the big advantage of going for this product, the CSR carbon fiber ductile over a fiberglass thing, is all about fit and finish. There's no way I could have gone to all this hassle and length of painting this car and then bolt what is essentially a wonky wing on the back of the car. Fit and finish is important to me. And again, big advantage of this, CAD designed to within 0.1 of a mil in terms of tolerance, the fit is going to be absolutely sublime. Part four is definitely, definitely, definitely finish time. For now, I'm gonna jump out of the way, let the guys remove this to the bin, get this on the back of the car, finish putting this car back together so we can all see how it looks like. Cannot wait.